We've been invited by the Canal and River Trust to celebrate a very special birthday. The Bingley Five Rise Locks, a tremendous feat of engineering, have just turned 250 years old. And we are going to become gongoozlers. That's the word for canal boat watchers. These locks were built as part of the Leeds-Liverpool Canal, a 127-mile stretch of canals linking the main industrial centres of the north. Sail that way and you go through Bradford and to Leeds. Go up there and you go to Liverpool. The canal took 46 years to complete. So, it's 1773 and you're sailing with your horse-drawn canal boat, because for most of the history of canals, the boats were pulled by horses, through the oldest part of the canal, from Bingley to Skipton. But you run into a slight problem. This massive hill is in the way. You could build a canal round it, but that's very expensive and would make the journey far longer. You could build a tunnel through it, but tunnel building at this time was quite complicated and dangerous if the tunnel collapsed. You can't go over it either, because water has a nasty habit of running downhill. So you need to keep the water level flat. How do you solve this problem? Well, you build what is essentially a water staircase. The idea is simple, but ingenious. Each of the five gates allow the boat to steadily ascend in stages whilst maintaining a flat water level. So the gates open, the water's let in, the boat moves up and goes onto the next level, and so on until it reaches the top. We're now at the top of the locks and we want to get downhill. So the boat is sailing on the canal. The first gate is opened, the water's let out, allowing the boat to sink lower to the next level until it reaches the bottom. Horsey takes a merry little walk down the hill and rejoins the boat at the bottom. Now, it's all well and good talking about how these locks work, but now it's time to have a go myself. In a boat, I mean. You won't trust me with these gates. In dulce jubilo, down, down, down we go. I'd never been on a canal boat before, so I was really excited to experience it for the first time. At each stage, the sluice gates were opened to allow the water out, lowering the boat further into the canal. Then, when we'd reached the right level, the lock gates were opened and we moved through to the next one. Repeat this four more times and you reach the bottom. The steady hum of the engine gave a real sense of tranquility to the journey. There was a gentleness about it. We weren't in any rush. We had time to stop and absorb the world around us, have a cup of tea, maybe a snack. In a world where we're constantly rushing about from one place to another, having this gentle mode of transportation floating serenely down the canal was a real change of pace. Mm-hmm. As well as the gentleness, you've got a real sense of the power involved. Not just the power of the engine, but the power of the water rushing down as the gates were opened. To be that close to the water gave a real understanding of how crucial water was to the Industrial Revolution, powering water mills, but especially canals. The journey lasted about 30 minutes, which sounds like a long time, but honestly didn't feel like it. In fact, it felt as though we'd descended the five locks rather quickly. And if you're so inclined, you can go on holiday on one of these canal boats, with a fair amount of luxury and comfort involved. I really enjoyed being able to experience this unique and historic mode of transportation. So we've spent all this time talking about the locks, but who actually built them? Well, thousands of anonymous navvies toiled away in canals and lock gates just like this. The navvies were the manual labourers who built the waterways and railways of Britain. Most were local men, but around a third were Irish. And building these locks was quite an impressive achievement. Each one stands 7 metres tall and weighs 6 tonnes. Don't let me do all the talking. Let's hear from some of the people who work with the Trust on this canal.
Hi, I'm Ruth Garrett. I'm one of the Regional Heritage Advisors in the Yorkshire region, and I help to look after the canal heritage assets that we've got.
How did this affect the local industries?
These locks were vitally important. Once they opened up, the first boats that went through, two boats went up to Skipton, and immediately the coal price was halved to that community. They were fantastic because they enabled more speedy transport of raw materials, so coal up to Skipton and Craven District, and limestone back for the Bradford quarries and ironworks down there. So it was absolutely fundamental enterprise and really revolutionised the industry and landscape in this particular region.
So what impact did these locks and canals have on the national infrastructure?
Well, the Leeds-Liverpool Canal is actually thought to be one of the most important regional types of infrastructure ever made. It absolutely skyrocketed the industrial economy. Without this canal, we wouldn't have had an industrial revolution, it would have been an industrial evolution.
Good morning, my name is Stuart Moody. I'm Heritage and Environment Manager for the Canal and River Trust Yorkshire North East region.
So what are the main challenges with preserving locks and canals like this one?
I mean, this site, Bingley Five Rise, is just an astounding bit of engineering, and it was amazing when it was built. And the challenge with looking after it is making sure that it works so that our users can use it safely, but doing that in a way that's sympathetic to the materials that it was built from, using the same materials where possible and the same techniques so that it's there for future generations.
When these locks were opened on the 21st of March 1774, 30,000 people came to see this feat of engineering. The Leeds Intelligencer reported that this joyful and much wished for event was welcomed with ringing of Bingley bells, a band of music, the firing of guns by the neighbouring militia, the shouts of the spectators, and all the marks of satisfaction that so important an acquisition merits. These locks, as well as thousands of other miles of historic waterways in Britain, are maintained by the Canal and River Trust, ensuring that they can be used and enjoyed by people now and in the future. To find out more about the Trust and their work, visit their website at www.canalrivertrust.org.uk. Well, this is the end of my journey down the Bingley Five Rise Locks, and this is the Gen Z Fred Dibner signing off.
Well, that was quite nice, wasn't it?
Welcome to Yorkshire Waterways. We sail as fast as I want, for as long as I want, because I'm captain, all right.